Okay, I'm going to use this applet to demonstrate some of the characteristics of the sampling distribution that we started in class. We have here the normal distribution with the mean of 16 and the standard deviation of 5. We're going to do a sample, and the sample size is in here. I'm going to start with a small sample size of 2 only, so take 2 people, and then we're going to animate, basically showing me how I take the 2 samples, and then I have the mean here. And here I'm going to try to construct the sampling distribution of the sample means of the average. And so the size here is only 2, there is only 2 observations. If I do it again, I get 2 different observations and so on and so forth. Every time I do, I get a different 2 observations, and I'm constructing here the sampling distribution. So for simplicity, I'm going to do it 10,000 times, and now we have the whole sampling distribution of 10,000 times taking a sample of size 2. And we notice that the mean of this population and the mean of the sample distribution is the same, and it's also well-shaped, even though the sample size is only 2. Now, this is amazing because we can use the normal distribution to calculate probabilities and many other things. Now, we can see what happens if the data is not normally distributed. Imagine we have a uniform distribution. What will happen when we do a sample size of 2? Again, sample size of 2, we animate. One time, there is a sample, we do it again, another 2, and so on and so forth. Now let's do it 10,000 times. Now you see, this doesn't look so nice as a bell curve. It looks, you know, like unimodal if you want, but not like a bell. A little bit strange as a bell. And that's because this is a uniform distribution, so the sample distribution doesn't behave very well when the population is not normal. However, we can do a trick. We can increase the sample size. Let's say here I will increase the sample size to 25. This applet is the maximum that let me do it. And do now an animation. We do it first one animation so you understand. Sample size of 25, we're going to have 25. This is my sample distribution. And from those 25 values, I'm going to have one average, one mean. And that's my mean for my sample. And I can do that again. And again, this takes a little longer. I'm going to expedite that on the next one. Right now, another sample of 25. Again, this is my sample distribution. And here, I'm constructing my sample distribution. So if I do that 10,000 times, look what happened. See, this is uniform, and now this looks like a bell shape. And also, the center of the population is the same as the center of my sampling distribution. So that's the amazing part. Now, this is an amazing applet in which you can see skew distribution and see what happened. And we can do the same. We can do directly the 10,000. And you see again, the mean here is only 8. And here the mean of the sampling distribution is still 8. Now we can also do something fun, which is custom. You know, when you collect your data, you may not know how it looks. So we can do something queer, like that. So this is a very strange data set. And you can play on your own. I give you the link. Now here, let's stop there. So now I have the mean of this is 13.56. If I do again, let's try for a second, sample size of 2, what do you predict will happen? Will I have here a normal distribution or will I have a weird form? Let's look, let's do 10,000 times. Oh, see, it's not normal distributed. And that's because the sample size is too small. But if you increase sample size at least to 25, this applet doesn't let me more than 25. But even with 25, since it's working great. So let's see. Check 25. Let's see if we do it 10,000 times. Oh, there you go. It's still normally distributed. So that's the beautiful part of it. That's the normal distribution on top of it, if you want to see it. The sample distribution is that first doesn't matter the population. So when you do your own project, so your final project and so on, you don't know the population, how it's distributed. Maybe it's weird like that, or maybe one of these ones we know more skew or normal. It doesn't matter what it is, because we know that the sampling distribution of this will be actually normally distributed as long as my sample size is large enough. I hope this clarifies at least that part of the assignment. So the center of the sampling distribution is the same as the center of the population, regardless of the shape of the population.